Eric, Vasily Lomachenko against Teofimo Lopez. What do you think?
Pick a fighter. I think Teofimo Lopez is a good fighter. He's explosive, he's fast, he's quick. Whether or not he's got the skill, I don't think he's got the skills that Lomachenko's got. But Lomachenko's not a big puncher either. So, you know, it could be an interesting fight.
I think a lot of people want to see that one. And then Ryan Garcia, Luke Campbell.
I don't know. Pick him. Ryan Garcia is a good fighter, but so is Luke Campbell.
Gervonta Davis and Leo.
I still feel like the fight's gonna lean towards Gervonta if he shows up. If he shows up, I'm leaning towards Gervonta. I like Leo. I think he's a great fighter. He's a proven fighter. I just think Gervonta's got the right chemicals, you know what I mean? The right attributes.
Okay, a couple more in the same. They're all in the same weight class. Linares and Fortuna.
Linares is probably a better technician, but he's a little long in the tooth. Fortuna, younger, hungry. It's going to be a war.
Okay, and the last one, Devin Haney, Gamboa.
Oh, I like Devin Haney. I don't know if he can beat Gamboa, but Gamboa is the guy that doesn't throw enough punches. Defensive wizards just don't throw enough punches.
Oh, and before I forget, Red Catch and Broner.
I think if Red Catch can keep the energy up, I think he can out-hustle him. But Broner still got a better technique, better skill set. Whether or not he'll be disciplined and show it all the way through the fight is another thing altogether.
You faced Broner with Paulie, right?
Yep.
How was that? How did you prepare for that one?
We worked on all the things that we do. We worked on the things we do and trying to make him fight when he didn't want to fight. And I thought Paulie won it. I thought Paulie outpointed him. And granted, Paulie's not a big puncher, but I thought he did enough to outscore him, outpoint him through the whole fight.
Everybody always talks about boxing about the biggest puncher, but props to Paulie for becoming a multi-division champion with only 7 knockouts, just pure skills.
Well, just because you're a big puncher doesn't mean that you're a better fighter than the next guy. It's a 10-point must system, right? You win points for each round.
But
if you're outlanding the guy, cleanly outlanding the guy, throughout a round, that's a 10-9 round.
Not only that, Eric, but I've seen some of Paulie's opponents after fights. Mm-hmm. He may not have power, but their face looks like they got hit by a train.
Yep.
The black eye, like the accumulation of jabs, the whole fight.
Yep.
He fought that one dude from England. I didn't recognize him.
Yeah. I mean, look at what is that kid's name? We fought him on our first title defense after we won the title.
In New York, right?
Pablo Cesar Cano. Paulie outboxed the shit out of Cano. You know what I mean? And they leaned towards giving it to Cano. You know, Paulie had his eye hanging out. I mean, had Cano's eye hanging out.
Well, you can't beat the politics, I'll tell you that much.
Which
yeah.
Is bullshit. So, you know, okay, speed bag. Let's go, speed bag. Okay? But Cano was a bigger puncher, but he couldn't hit Paulie.
That's true.
He couldn't hit Paulie. Paulie was hitting with everything. You know?
That's true. So, it's boxing.
It's all about what you're looking at and what you like to see. That's how the judges go. Some judges appreciate good boxing.
Or they appreciate the A side.
Yeah, of course. And some judges prefer big power punches. So it all depends on what they like.
That's true.